Thank you, Deputy Speaker. The NDIS is a bipartisan scheme that gives family and people with a disability a choice. Well, that's what it's supposed to be. It's not supposed to make things more difficult or cause stress to participants. Yet we see time and time again Australians with a disability, their families and their carers, struggling to deal with a system that has been stripped to the bone by this government and includes too much red tape. The Coalition are deliberately underfunding the NDIS so they can prop up their budget position, especially around a lack of staff. And they're doing this at the expense of my constituents with a disability. Where the NDIS has been successful, it has had incredible results for those Australians who need it. When it works, it allows people to live fulfilling lives and participate in their communities. However, we've heard time and time again in this chamber the personal stories of those where the NDIS has failed. It's a repeat story. Members have stood here and explained the shocking stories of their constituents who are without funding, without assistive technology, and are unable to get clarity on their plans. The stories are shocking, but sadly all too familiar. One of my constituents is a quadruple amputee. He had an NDIS annual review in August 2008 and had no funding for assistive technology in that plan. He sent a request for the AT just before Christmas last year, gave the required quotes, the justifications and reports. He requires funding for two AT items: replacement sockets, liners and sleeves for his prosthetic legs because his prosthetics no longer fit correctly. This means it's dangerous for him to move around. He also needs domestic prosthetics so he can put them on himself and can go to the bathroom at night or for any emergencies. The issue here is that the bathroom modifications that were done to apparent NDIS specifications do not allow him to use a standard commode, and the higher commode is too dangerous for him to use without the domestic prosthetics. Despite this, he still manages to work 3 days a week, relying on his prosthetics to be able to do his job. In January, he came to my office as he'd received no response on his application for AT. When I inquired with the NDIS as to where his application was at, the answer I received was that the request had been sitting from the occupational therapist, unactioned for months. It took until March until his plan was reinstated and his funding restarted.